as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home. Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons that fill you.
We gather together in this beautiful place on this remarkable day to bear witness to the marriage of Erica Lynn Epstein and Jeffrey Michael Lewis. This is a place that holds special meaning for the couple. It was where they first two met as children. In this chapel, they celebrated their faith with their families, learning who they are, where they come from, and dreaming of where their life would lead them. It has led them to this moment, when they declare their love and devotion to each other in the eyes of God. And while we watch as they take the first steps toward realizing their dream of family, we remember that each of us in this room hold a bond of love for Erica and Jeffrey. All of us share in their joys and hold steady in their sorrow. We share memories with them, but also a future ahead. Like two rivers that have each wend their way into one, Erica and Jeffrey have invited you to witness their union of one love, one heart. Splendor is upon everything. Blessing is upon everything. Who is full of this abundance? Bless this groom and bride.
Baruch ato Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, barei pri hagafen. Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe, who created the fruit of the vine.
Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe, who created everything for your glory.
Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe, shaper of humanity.
Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe, who has shaped humanity in your image, patterned after your image and likeness, and enabled them to perpetuate this image out of their own being. Blessed are you, Adonai, shaper of humanity.
Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, who has given us a vision of the paradise we dream of creating with our lives and called it redemption. We praise you, O Lord, who created the commitment of marriage as a foretaste of redemption.
Blessed are you, Adonai our God,
ruler of the universe, who created joy and gladness, groom and bride, merriment, song, dance and delight, love and harmony, peace and companionship. Adonai our God, may there soon be heard in the city of Judea and the streets of Jerusalem the voice of joy and the voice of gladness, the voice of the bridegroom and the voice of the bride, the rapturous voices of the wedded form their bridal chambers, and of young people feasting and singing. Blessed are you, Adonai, who gladden the bridegroom together with the bride.
It's no secret both Eric and Jeffrey hold a special love for music. In life, they were born at exactly the right time to find one another. But in music, their children will probably grow up thinking mom and dad were born 3 decades too late. A love of music reflects the love of marriage. Husband and wife must learn to harmonize with one another, not cancel each other out. And yet, there are also those moments between songs, the silence that gives pause to the rhythms of one's life. It's in these moments we are reminded that we came into this world as an individual, that we join in union with our family, our friends, and if we're lucky, with someone to share our life with forever. We never forget that we have our own soul, sealed by God, belonging only to us. And when life gives us pause, we listen to the silence in our hearts, and we're reminded of what a gift we've truly been given, to be in this moment, and to share it with those we love. Listen to yourself, and in that quietude, you might hear the voice of God. These were the last words written by Maya Angelou before her passing this week. Let us be present for Erica and Jeffrey. Let us pause now to be silent in our love for them. We bear witness today not just with our eyes and our ears, but most importantly with our hearts. In the silent recesses of your own heart, may you feel the touch of God's grace and the love that Erica and Jeffrey hold for each of you.